first one we're gonna start with today are these paper flowers. And we're gonna use a technique today called quilling. Quilling is, actually I just looked it up because I wasn't really sure of the history of it, and it turns out quilling has been around since the ancient Egyptian times, but it's still very popular today. And basically the art of quilling is rolling paper around something smaller and creating these little paper rolls. So we are gonna be doing quilling to create these paper flowers. And this flower is inspired by a hyacinth. A hyacinth is usually blue, purple, pink, or white, and it blooms in the spring. Comes from a bulb which is planted in the fall. So the things that you're gonna need today, you need some sort of a ruler. This is an extra long ruler. You need something that you can roll your paper around. So I have this little dowel, and I also have just a regular pencil. Obviously, the thinner it is, the more tight you can get your roll. But I did the bigger one with the pencil, and the smaller one I did with the dowel. So you can kind of see a little bit of a difference. The paper I'm using is just construction paper, but they recommend using something like cardstock. So a little bit tougher paper if you've got it. So I've pulled some white, purple, pink, and then for our stem, we're gonna use green. So go ahead and get different colors. Obviously, you don't have to stick with the colors that the flowers are in nature. You can be creative with that. You're gonna need a pair of scissors for cutting. And then I've got some glue. I also have a paintbrush to use with my glue, because sometimes when you want to apply glue to a larger area, you might wanna paint it on. And then I have a glue stick as well. And then my backup, if you need it, is a little bit of tape to make sure that while the glue is drying, it's not gonna fall apart, okay? So I'm going to talk you through the steps of creating the stem. I haven't added leaves to this yet, but we'll also add leaves, and then how to create your flower. Okay. Step one, let's start with this pink paper. We're going to go ahead and create one of our flower pieces. So what you're going to do is get your ruler, and you're just going to make a straight line. So you do need a pencil just to kind of draw a straight line to create a rectangle. And then cut that out. So once you have a rectangle, you're gonna create little cuts, slits down. If you want to be more precise, you can measure it about a half inch across. Because I'm not gonna worry about that, we're just gonna kinda eyeball it. And you need to stop before you get to the end, okay? So we're gonna just cut down to about right there, and then stop, and then continue along. I'm gonna show you a little update. This is what I've got so far. It's gonna start to kind of look like grass, like you're making some grass. Okay, voila. So we've gotten to our end, woo! Now, here comes the quilling. To do quilling, basically we're gonna be rolling the paper around something that's round, like this dowel. So I'm just gonna start from this end. I'm gonna take the dowel and I'm gonna put it at the end of the first strip, and I'm going to hold it while I tightly roll it. You don't wanna rip the paper. I'm gonna take it down to the end where I left a little spot, hold it for a moment, and then go ahead and pull out the dowel. And when you let it go, the paper will be in a spiral. Now, this is construction paper, so it's kind of not super thick and it's not super strong. If you do this with cardstock, if you've got cardstock, I think it's gonna turn out a little bit better for you. I'm just gonna continue on down, creating my little rolls, quilling, and as you work, you might see some that start to come undone a little bit. That's okay. We're actually going to wrap this whole thing around our stem that we'll get to in just a moment. So I'm going to keep on rolling. If you do only have a pencil to work with, your rolls just might be a little bit bigger. And that's okay too, because the flowers are going to turn out lovely.
All my life I stand for you.
Okay, so step one, you should have your full row that you cut quilled. Okay, so this is gonna be the flower part. Now we're gonna work on our stem. So you wanna get your green paper, if you have green paper, and then we're gonna cut a little rectangle of that again. So if you wanna use your ruler, use your ruler. You can also eyeball it. And we're just gonna cut sort of a similar size, a little bit thicker for this because we want it to be a little bit taller, okay? So you've got a rectangle. You're gonna get your dowel or your pencil, whatever you're using to twirl. And I actually found this a little helpful to just put a little bit of glue on here, a little glue stick. You don't wanna glue it to your dowel. So I'm just gonna put a few little stripes on it just to kind of help it as it's twisting. So we're actually gonna twist this one like that, like in a big circle, and we're gonna make it into almost like a straw. So we're gonna wrap the corner around the dowel, and you're gonna hold it on nice and tight and just roll the paper. Whoop. See, it comes undone a little bit. Might have to take a few turns. Roll the paper tightly as you can toward the other direction. Keep rolling, keep rolling, keep rolling. Make sure you leave a way to get that dowel out. And when you get to the end, I actually, before you get to the end, go ahead and add some glue stick or glue there, so that as you roll it, it's got a lot to hold on to itself. And give it a second. I'm just gonna pull out the dowel. Make sure that it's, you gotta kinda hold where it's glued. Remember I said we had our tape just in case. If you wanna do a little piece of tape just to hold it on there, I think that is fine. You can take it off later, just put it on nice and loosely so it doesn't rip your paper. But you can kind of see, because it's not used to being twirled up like that, it's gonna try to unravel. So I'm just gonna put a little tape right there until it's had a chance to set up. Now, here's the fun part, because what we're gonna do is attach this to here, and we're gonna kind of spiral it down the stem, and it's gonna create this shape, okay? So to do that, we're gonna switch to some wet glue. It's what I found works a little bit better. So your hands actually are gonna get a little messy, but hey, it's art. That is totally okay to get a little messy with art. So I'm gonna start by just putting some glue at the top of the stem. I'm just using my paintbrush to paint it on. You can use glue stick. I think wet glue works just a bit better. Now, to start your spiral, you're going to attach, obviously you want your curls facing out, so you're gonna attach the very top part to the top part of your stem and hold it there for a moment, and then we're gonna start to twist it, and it's gonna go down like a layer every time. So just a nice gradual descent of the flower petals. Add a little more glue as you go. I'm just gonna go ahead and get it filled up so that I don't have to keep stopping to add my glue. Boom, boom, boom. No problems. All right, and we are twisting around, holding it tight as we go so that it's really attaching to that glue. As you can see, we're getting further down the stem. It's looking pretty cute. Starting to look like a flower now, isn't it? And so as you're going, you're just kind of holding with one hand, making sure that you've got glue there to hold it on. I'm gonna go ahead and add a little more glue here. I like this pink one too. It's gonna look good with those blue ones I did earlier. So adding just a bit more glue around the edges and continuing to spiral. Spiral, spiral, spiral. And then when you get to the end, just like we did before, it might want to come up. And so I'm just gonna kind of hold it for a little bit. And if you want to add a little tape or a little extra glue, if you need it. But this is what we're going for. We're gonna go ahead and add the last little step, which is our leaves. I haven't added any leaves yet. And then you also can check on that tape that you added if you wanna take that off. I wouldn't leave the tape on. But if, especially if your little vase that you want to use for them isn't clear like mine, the tape's not going to show anyway. So go ahead and put it in there, okay? So now we're going to create the leaves that go on our flower. I do have a little tape on this holding this one together. The leaves are pretty simple. So what you're going to do is take another part of the green paper. This time we're going to look, try to get a smaller rectangle. So kind of like this shape. We're going to do an accordion fold. We've done an accordion fold with a couple other projects. We did it with our rosette and we did it with our other flowers, our tissue paper flowers, okay? So what you're going to do is do your accordion fold. You're going to fold it, flip, fold, flip, fold, and flip. And so you really want about four little sections and it should look like a little zigzag paper like that. You're gonna keep it folded and now we're gonna turn this into sort of more of a leaf shape. So starting from the middle, we're gonna cut up from the middle to the top and make like a little point at the top. Now we're gonna cut from the other side, we're gonna cut from the point down to the middle. And when you open it up, it should look kind of like blades of grass. I'm noticing this one didn't go very far, so I'm gonna kind of just fix that real quick. Make sure that each layer is going down about the same amount so that when we glue it on, nobody's left out. I didn't realize I had five. That's gonna look cute. So let me get the one I've been working on. And basically, we're gonna add some glue to the bottom part of this, okay? Because we're gonna do another sort of spiral. I'm gonna cut a little bit off of the end of that. Glue stick, wet glue, really load it on there good so that it doesn't come off. All right. Now, just like we did before, we're doing almost like a spiral down. So we're gonna take the corner of this right here. We're gonna have our leaves facing up, obviously. And we're gonna start spiraling our leaf paper down and around itself. And as we go around, there we go. As we go around, our leaves will kind of stick out the side like so, okay? And then at the end, remember, add a little bit of glue there to make sure that stays together. And then you can tape it while it's drying is probably a good idea. Ooh, I got a little crazy with my wet glue. That's all right. Okay, this is how you can create a bouquet of paper hyacinth to celebrate our springtime and practice the art of quilling. So I hope that you guys try this out. I really, really like this. I've never made this type of paper flower before, and I just think that they are actually very gorgeous. And you know what the best part about a paper flower? It's not gonna wither and it's not gonna die, and so you can keep that spring feeling as long as you want.